Good afternoon, boys and girls. For the newcomers that have joined us today, I'm David Otieno. This is class 5 and I do teach here mathematics. I'm a math teacher of this class. Now today we are going to learn how to get the perimeter of a rectangle. In the previous chapter, we did how to solve fractions, but today we are going to discuss the perimeter. Perimeter basically means area around the figure. That is the perimeter. It is the distance all around the figure. Now, when you are told to get the perimeter of a rectangle like this, there is a formula that we use to get the perimeter of each figure. Like, for example, this is a rectangle. To get the perimeter of a rectangle, the formula we use is 2 into length plus width. This is the formula of getting the perimeter of a rectangle. Now, if we have this is the length and this is the width. Now, when we are told to solve or get the perimeter of this rectangle, we use the formula which is 2 into length plus width. Now, we say 2 into length, here we are given 12. So, you say 2 into 12 plus width, width we have 8. Now, when you add the width, you add what is in the bracket, the 12 plus 8, you get 20. So you say 2, this bracket means 10. This what 2 here, it means you multiply. So you multiply by what you get after adding 12 plus 8, which is 20. Therefore, the perimeter of this rectangle will be 2 times 20, that one you get 40. Now, units. When you look at the figure, you see the 8 has the unit. The unit here is centimeter. So you make sure you write centimeter. You don't square unit. We square when you are told to get the area. In perimeter, the units remain that way. You don't square. You don't put square. You don't put a square here. When you square here, you will get a wrong answer. You will be wrong. But when you are told to get the area, that is when you square. Hope that is clear. Now, when you are told to get the perimeter, but there is another way you can as well do it this way. If this side is 8, this side is also 8. This one 12, this one becomes 12. You can as well add 12 plus 8 plus 12 plus 8. Still you will land at 40. There are very many ways of killing a rat or a mouse. So you can use whichever formula to get, but the formula that I would advise you is this, the formula which is 2 into length plus width. That is the formula of getting a perimeter of a rectangle. But you can add this, because this side is the same as this, and you get your answer. I hope that is clear. Now we are going to get, for example, that is, now, if you are told to get the perimeter of a rectangle, when the figure is given and the length is there, let us see example 2. If you are given the perimeter, for example, if here you are given 22 centimeter and here you are given 4 centimeter, then you are not given anything, then you are told that the rectangle given below has the perimeter of 22 centimeter. Find length. Here you are not given the length. How can we get the length? And here we apply the formula. The reason why I told you that you have to write the formula. You must master the formula. Because when it is like this and you start adding, you will get to the track, but it will somehow confuse you. So here you just need to apply the formula. You say perimeter of a rectangle is equal to 2 into length plus width. Therefore, the perimeter you already been given. So you say perimeter is 22, which is equal to 2 into length you don't have, plus the width. Width we have 4 centimeter. Therefore, you say 22 is equal to, you open the bracket, 2 times x you get 2x, plus 2 times 8 you get 8. Therefore, you say 2x is equal to, you remove this 8. When 8, you bring it to the other side, or you can, as you decide to put, take 22 the other side, you say 2x is equals to 22, take away 8. Therefore, 2x is equals to, this one is called collecting the like terms. You collect the like terms together. This one is 2x, and this one is this, this and this, they are the like terms. This one is unlike terms. You cannot subtract this from the, this from this. That one is impossible. Now, after collecting the like terms, you say 2x is equals to 22, take away 8. 2x is equals to 22, take away 8, you get 14. Therefore, you divide both sides. Because you want to remain with the unknown, the x is unknown. What do you do to remain with unknown? You divide both sides by 2. Both sides by 2. So the 2 cancel 2, and x remains alone, the unknown. So by 2, 1 by 2, 7. Therefore, x is equals to 7 centimeters. That is how we get the length. So when you apply your formula, you will get to 7. So meaning x is equals to 7 centimeters. Now, when you are asked to get the perimeter of a square, this is was a rectangle. Now, when you are told to get the perimeter of a square, let's see how we can work or get the perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square. But before we go to perimeter of a square, I would like you to try out the following. Try out the following. Try out the following. Try out the following. Number one. Find the perimeter. You try out these two, and then after that we shall see whether you understood what we have learned or not. And next time I think for that is enough for you, because when we go do a lot, you may forget. So this one is enough for today. Next time I know we shall look at the formula on how we can find the perimeter of a square. Then we have dealt with a rectangle. Next time, I know we are going to learn how to get the perimeter of a square. Hope you are okay and you have understood. So we'll try to work out this one, and I will see whether you got what I said. Thank you very much, and next time better.